Ready to unlock the full potential of Affinity Designer 2.5 on your iPad in just 10 minutes? In this video, I'll guide you through the essential tools and features you need to know to use the app with confidence. If we haven't met before, my name is Nicole from iPad Calligraphy. I teach curious creatives how to use the iPad for lettering and design. In this video, we're going to take a detailed tour of all the tools and features in Affinity Designer 2.5, and I'll also cover one crucial feature missing from Affinity Designer and show you an easy, free workaround so you don't miss a beat in your creative process. Let's dive in. One of the most impressive things about Affinity Designer is the ability to switch seamlessly between two powerful modes, the vector persona and the pixel persona. So this means you can create sharp, scalable vector graphics and then add pixel-based details like textures or shading all within the same project without the need to jump between multiple apps. Another standout feature is the Command Controller, a handy on-screen tool that gives you extra functionality without needing a keyboard. For example, you can easily constrain movements or rotations for pixel-perfect precision. These are just a couple of reasons why Affinity is a game-changer for the creative work on the iPad. So the iPad version of the app is a one-time purchase of $19.99 rather than an expensive monthly subscription like Adobe, which can cost over $600 a year. The main reason people turn to Affinity Designer is for the vector tools, and we'll look at those in just a minute. By the way, you can grab a free cheat sheet with everything condensed in an easy-to-follow guide so you can focus on learning without worrying about taking notes. The link to that is in the description below. So when you open the app, you'll see the gallery screen, and this is where you can create or import documents. There's a lessons tab down here on the left with some useful tutorials to go through. And there's also access to the learning portal via the help menu here. The documents on your gallery screen are not saved anywhere else, by the way. So it's worth remembering to save out your work regularly. To do that, you just click on the hamburger menu and tap save as, which is just like exporting your file. You can save it locally to your iPad, or better yet, if you have iCloud and Dropbox connected, just save it there. That will prevent your iPad clogging up with excess files. So you can move your documents around easy, just similar to the iPhone. Hold down on one, they all start to wiggle and you can just change their order. To create a new document, just tap on the new icon on the left and choose new document. The next screen will give you some presets as well as the option to create your own custom size. I usually work with 3000 by 3000 pixels in RGB format. This will all depend on your end goals for the project though, so when you're finished here, just tap OK. So now we're in the interface, and as mentioned, you can move between those two personas, vector or pixel. To do this, you just tap the icon in the top left corner and you'll see those options in the drop-down menu. Something else you might notice that's a bit unusual is you've got this gray circle with an outline in the bottom left corner of the screen. This is the Command Controller, and it adds extra functionality to certain tools so you don't have to rely on keyboard shortcuts or menus. For example, you can use it with the Move tool and it'll align objects perfectly or rotate them in precise 15 degree increments. This is a lifesaver for logo design or layouts. It's worth experimenting with other tools as well, like the pen tool, shape tool, text tool, to discover more of those context-specific enhancements that it offers. Another thing that's very useful to know, if you hold down this little question mark in the bottom right corner of the screen, you'll see the name for all the tools. This is really handy if you're new to the app and you're trying to find a specific tool. If you're transitioning from another iPad app like Procreate, you'll be happy to know that many of the gestures are quite similar. For example, you can undo with two-finger tap on the screen, redo with a three-finger tap. You can also pinch in and out to zoom. However, one difference you might notice is the canvas rotation. In Procreate, you can rotate the canvas using a two-finger circular motion, but Affinity doesn't enable this by default. To activate it, simply head to the gallery screen, tap the settings option in the left menu here, and navigate to the tools section. Here you'll find an option called Allow Canvas Rotation in All Tools. turn that on and then go back to your canvas and you'll be able to rotate it just like you can in Procreate. You'll find most of the main tools down the left side. Remember, you can always tap that question mark to see what they are. The most common are the Move tool at the top, the Pen tool for creating custom vector shapes, the Vector Brush tool. Unlike Procreate, which relies on raster brushes, Affinity's Vector Brush tool creates paths that are fully editable and resolution independent, ensuring that your designs remain crisp and scalable at any size. So you can change the brush type here in the right menu, and the categories are in this top flyout menu. You can also load custom brushes that you've purchased as well. I use custom brushes to create elegant strokes for lettering projects, which are perfect for logos, invitations, or digital art. Once I've drawn a stroke, I can select the white arrow tool, known as the Node tool, and this allows me to edit the individual points along the path, making it easy to adjust and refine the shape to suit your design perfectly. Before we dive into what I consider Affinity's biggest advantage, let me show you something it excels at compared to most other iPad apps, and that's its text features. Many fonts include what are called alternate characters, variations on the letters that add more style and variety to your designs. Most iPad apps, including Procreate, ignore these alternate characters and only provide the standard font set. But Affinity stands out because it gives you full access to everything a font has to offer, and it does this in a really user-friendly way. For example, if you use the text tool to type out a word, simply double tap to select it, and from the top menu you can easily change the font. I'll choose one called Lost and Master because I know that it has some beautiful alternate characters. Next, I can open the text property menu on the right and select the Glyph Browser. This tool displays all the character options for the font. Just double tap the alternate character you want to use, and it's that simple. Just make sure that the specific letter you want to replace is selected first. If you're designing something like a wedding invitation, you can easily swap the standard A for a more elaborate version with elegant swirls or flourishes, and it really adds that personal touch to your project. As mentioned earlier, the vector tools are a major reason why people turn to Affinity Designer. And as promised, let's talk about one of the features that many artists miss in Affinity and how to work around it effectively. Adobe Illustrator has a feature called Live Trace, or otherwise known as Image Trace. This allows you to automatically convert a raster or pixel image into vector art. A fantastic tool for lettering artists who create in Procreate, but then also need a scalable, editable vector version of their work. While Affinity Designer doesn't have a built-in Live Trace feature, there's a really easy workaround. You can use Adobe Capture, which is a free app, to convert your Procreate artwork into vector shapes. Simply import your pixel file into Adobe Capture, convert it to a vector shape, and export it as an SVG file. Once you've done this, you can import that SVG directly into Affinity Designer and continue refining your artwork. It's a quick and efficient way to bridge the gap. And now let me show you what Affinity does exceptionally well with this. If you want to edit your vector lettering, just select the pencil tool and ensure that the sculpt setting is enabled, and then redraw over the stroke. This allows you to just adjust and reshape your design using the Apple Pencil, making those edits as natural as if you were drawing on paper. It's a feature that truly takes advantage of the iPad's interface and gives you an incredible amount of creative control. So now you know how to navigate Affinity Designer 2.5 and you're ready to start creating some vector art on your iPad. Remember, it's all about experimenting, so dive in and get creative, try out the tools to see how they work. And don't forget to download the cheat sheet below. It's packed with everything that we covered here today, so you can focus on creating without distraction. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more, and don't miss the next video where we'll explore 6 things that Affinity Designer does better than Procreate. I'll see you there.